Welcome to Office Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you're used to managing devices, it used to be about locking down the entire device. Now with the cloud and BYOD, it really transcends that to be able to protect files at the data level. We're going to talk about that in the next 10 minutes and all the things that we're doing from Office 365, Intune, and Azure. Stay tuned. I'm joined again by Nasos Kladakis. Welcome.
Nice to be here.
So when you think about mobile device management, what are we really trying to solve for?
So we are trying to solve the enterprise mobility challenge. And in order to do that, we have to see it from two different perspectives, the end user and the IT. And end users want to access everything from everywhere and being able to access their personal data and their business data from any device.
So when you think about it from the IT perspective, we also want permissions-based access. We want to make sure regardless of what device you're on, it should be platform agnostic. The identity, the person who needs access to the data can only access that data. And also we're doing something here around segregating personal and work information.
And for that specific point, I want to clarify that users want to access, let's say, their Facebooks and their Twitters next side by side with their corporate data. They want that separation.
So it means that you don't have to carry two devices around like you may have done in the past. And also when we think about management, it's really moving down to the data versus just the device level. So we want to be able to protect at the file level anything on that device.
Yes, actually we protect in many different levels, but everything starts from identity. We want to be sure that you have secure single sign-on. The second step is to go and manage applications and devices.
And one of the things that we're doing with Office is we're actually instrumenting those applications to make sure that they can be managed. One of the cool things now with Office 365 and Windows Intune is I can enroll through Word, Excel, PowerPoint. It's not just about connecting mail to that device, but also connecting through those other apps. So OneDrive for Business, for example, becomes that enrollment mechanism. So regardless of how I connect to data, I need to be able to protect that.
And you know, by getting that separation, end users get their devices back. It doesn't have to be managed devices of their enterprise. And besides identity and mobile and application management, we can go even deeper. We can protect data. We can have encryption that will follow data wherever they are, even when they leave the device.
Let's have a look at some demonstrations of all of this working, because we have some really cool things to show across all the different workloads that we have from Office 365, also into Intune and Azure. So we're gonna move to my device here, and you'll see that I have a brand new compliance center in Office 365, and that's got a few new capabilities. It's got archiving, device management, data loss prevention. A lot of these apply regardless of whether I'm using a mobile device or whether I'm using a traditional PC. Just to show you what I can do from a conditional access perspective, I wanna make sure that the devices that connect to my infrastructure are actually healthy. So some of the new things that we can do in terms of access requirements that weren't in Exchange Active Sync, for example, are the ability to check for rooted or jailbroken devices. Those things I can do right within my console here to make sure that these types of devices that we can't ensure are safe are able to connect to the devices can't connect to my corporate resources. Some of the other things that I can do as well, some configurations. A lot of people ask me, well, can I stop people from screen printing their device? Yes, we have all of that built in. So I can do things like block screen capture right on the device. You can see it here. But I have now new capabilities that might not have been things within Exchange Active Sync in the past. So we have additional controls, also around 50 different PowerShell controls we can do there in terms of having even more granular control over the device. But I'll cancel out of that because I want to show you how you do selective wipe within Office 365. If we go and look at our list of managed devices here, we'll see that we have a few devices in our tenant. We've got now a couple of new capabilities, and I'll just zoom into those capabilities. So if we think about what we had before, we had something called full wipe. So if we look at full wipe, what that will do, and I'll be careful not to press that because somebody's device will get wiped and reset back to its original factory state. What would happen there is the device would get set back to the state that it would when you unboxed it. Now with selective wipe, we can basically just remove the information, the data, and reset the applications to where they were when you initially installed them before you signed in to try to access data. So that means that you can leave everything back on the device, the pictures, everything else, untouched so that users can use the device that they typically own. And that way they don't have to carry two devices with them. So really exciting stuff natively inside of Office 365. But it gets even better when we add Intune to that, right?
Right. So let me explain that the concept now. This is a personal device that is enrolled in Intune. And the user doesn't really want to have a fully locked device. He just wants to have a managed environment, a managed applications. So you can see here in my iPad that I have different applications. And if I click to my notes, for example, I can get into them with no problem. But if I click one of the managed devices, you will see what will happen. So this Intune enrolled device has Outlook. The moment I will click to Outlook, you see that I need to provide a PIN. So by using this secure PIN, I have access now to this managed application. And let me show what I can do through that managed application. Let's say I'm looking at this specific mail, and I'm trying to copy that part of my email. Then let's suppose that I will try to paste that part to a personal application, let's say Notes. If I go here, you will see that paste is not even an option. So whatever I copied from a managed application controlled by Intune wasn't even possible to paste it here. If I go to Word, let's say let's open Word, which is also a protected device, I can now, by clicking here, you will see paste is possible. And I can paste it because also Word is protected. So you see that I can do both of these things. And if I will try to save that Word document, let's say, and the same goes for Outlook and attachments of Outlook and stuff like that, if I go to save the device, I have many different options. If I try to save it in my Dropbox, which is a personal space, you will see that I'm not even able to do that because this is not allowed. But if I go to the OneDrive of the Contoso Cloud OneDrive, I am able to share it. Or let's show actually that. Let's say save. You see, it says your administrator doesn't allow saving to personal locations. So although this is my device, I have a full separation between what is mine and what is business controlled. Now, that's okay about Office applications and Office 365 probably. What about other SaaS applications?
Right, because it really goes beyond just protecting the device, because you have other business applications, maybe other personal applications you might try to connect to via the web or other mechanisms. This SaaS also gives you a way to protect the logins with those. We have abilities now within Azure Active Directory to do a lot more in terms of protecting experiences.
Exactly, and if you remember my point on having secure single sign-on, this is what I'm going to do right now. So I'm going to an application, a mobile application that is available in all mobile devices and of course in iPads. So, and I will log in as a user. I will be that user for now. Better.
There we go.
You see, I was recognized, the environment changed to my familiar colors, and I will use my password. The thing you are going to see now, it's a single place that I will be able to sign in to many different SaaS applications. So you see Office 365, but you can see Box and Enterprise Twitter account and everything. Everything is here. The Enterprise Twitter account is protected. I don't know the actual password. I can just sign in from here. I can see my Workday account. And look at that. Those ugly icons are icons from web applications hosted on premises, published through Azure Active Directory Premium to this device. And I can take conditional access and special protection to different applications here. So if I click Twitter, probably I will be there with no protection. But if I decide to go to my on-premises application, let's say I want to go to my legacy sales tracking application, which is an application from on-premises, and click on that icon, you will see now that I will be prompted for a second factor of authentication. So I'm expecting for that phone call.
This is really great because it means that I only need to know that one set of credentials to get to all these different services. Now
here
it's one
it
call
is
coming in.
Okay, I'm going to answer. You have to believe me that the real nice lady says, Nasos, if it was you, press your PIN and you will be in. But if it wasn't you, press £0 and your account will be blocked and an alert will be created. So although probably someone has your device and your password, he doesn't have your mobile device, your phone, so you can block him. This is real protection.
This is great because it works, again, on even sites that might have only a single factor of authentication. Now you can require that, even if it's, say, your company's Twitter account or your company's Facebook account, those things you can protect via multi-factor authentication, via that same login that you would have to access even internal services all in one place, even with an iPad. And we saw with a phone, multiple factors of authentication.
Right, and now I'm going to show you also how you can discover all those SaaS applications that your end users are using. So I'm going now to a management console. Let's pretend that now I'm an administrator. And I'm going to portal.azure.com. And there you will see a new capability that we have announced recently at the keynote on Monday. And I am admin for this case.
So one of the things that you're going to want to do is actually figure out what people are using, right?
Exactly. This is my goal now. So I know that I have to protect their Office applications. I know that I had to protect their Box and their other applications that you have just seen. But let's see. Are you sure that you know exactly what your end users are using? Let's do. We have a tool to do that. And yes, we have. The tool is called Cloud App Discovery. It's available through Azure Active Directory. And I'm going to click here to Cloud App Discovery in Azure Active Directory. And you will see that you have the capability to see what exactly your users are using. In our case, we have 462 new applications discovered in our managed devices environment. And 52 users are using these applications. And I can drill down and see exactly which these applications are, how much they are used. And by that, you can say that, OK, I see that my users are using, let's say, SearchForge, 10 of them. And they are using this application heavily. And I see that this application is still unmanaged. Let's change that. Let's bring those users under a managed environment and give them secure single sign-on and all the benefits that you have seen. So when I discover the application, I can click Manage from here and bring them in. Or I can go even further, click on the application, and get a view of how many users and how much they are using the application, and even further, which users. I can see their names. I can see their devices. So I can decide if this is an important application to bring in. This is not even enough. OK, now you know your users, what your users are using, but you don't know from where they're accessing that and if they are really your users. So in order to help you even more with that, with Azure Active Directory Premium, we have the security, advanced security reporting. And I'm going to show you a few of these reports. So in the reporting part of Azure Active Directory Premium, now that we know which applications we have to secure, now we have mobile application management and Office 365 MDM, now that we have everything, let's be sure that our users are using their applications consistently and safely. So if a user is accessing an application from an anonymizer, from Tor anonymizer, you can know that now. If he's trying to access the same applications from two different places at the same time, let's say sign-ins from multiple geographies, he cannot be in North Korea and in Chicago, Illinois at the same time. So probably something is wrong with this guy. And you can take actions. You can click on him and block him because he cannot come from North Korea to here in 14 minutes. So either you block him or you can enable multi-factor authentication for him.
So really taking it, again, beyond all of just the devices itself and really going with a lot more intelligence around how people are logging in, we can have manageability there in place without sacrificing end user productivity, right?
Yes, this is really important. We can give security with productivity at the same time.
That's about all the time we have to show today in terms of mobile device management and the things that we're doing to go beyond the device. So of course, you can keep current with all of these discussions on the Office blog. You guys have your own blog as well, right?
Of course. This is Enterprise Mobility Suite, microsoft.com/EMS. And you will see all the things that we have just discussed.
Thanks for watching and goodbye for now.